This life was explained to me through the story of Nanuruluk, the colossal bear. No paws, teeth, nor others' patience measured to its own. It walked the earth for many seasons, growing until the land was too small for its comfort.
David, it's me. I didn't wake you, did I?
No, I'm up. Just fixing myself a coffee. So where are you now?
I just reached the Parks Canada research ship. Freezing my ass off waiting for Dr. Gervais to come show me around the boat. It's minus 15 here, more like minus 20 with the wind chilling.
Yeah, I didn't send you there to report the weather, Tana. Did you get a chance to read over the documents I sent?
Yes, sir. Got it all in my backpack in case I need a quick refresher. But as of 4 a.m. this morning, I'm a full-fledged expert on the Franklin expedition. Ready to turn it all into a great story. So long as I don't pass out in the middle of the interview.
Damn it, Dana. I thought I told you to get a good night's rest.
That was the plan until my connecting flight was delayed for 8 hours. But at least it gave me plenty of time to get my mind off that weird dream.
Can you please just focus for a couple of days? I don't want to regret giving you this opportunity.
Uh-oh. Sounds like someone needs to finish his coffee. Well, can't stand around all day chit-chatting, David. Some of us have work to do. Hello? Hello? I have an appointment with Mr. Gervais. Alan?
So you're the journalist. How long were you planning on loitering outside? You want to freeze to death or come aboard?
You must be Alan Gervais. I'm Tina Hippolyte.
Tina, I can't wait to catch up, but my hands are full right now. Why don't you take a look around, try not to touch anything, and we'll get acquainted later, yes?
I just wanted to ask if you...
Fantastic.
What's a nice ship like the HMS Terror doing in a place like this?
You know, we're not completely surprised by where it ended up. We knew the Terra had been stuck in the ice with the Erebus about 100 kilometers north of here.
I read about that. That's where things really started to go wrong for the Franklin expedition, right?
Right. And since the Erebus was found further south in 2014, we figured the Terra would be somewhere between those two points. Still, it was a stroke of luck that anyone found it at all, and in such good condition.
It must be so exciting. Imagine all the things we could learn from this.
We won't have to imagine for much longer. Hey, are you gonna use any of that in your piece?
I'm Tina from the Discoverer. Mind if I ask a few questions? I understand you've made some interesting discoveries.
Interesting would be an understatement. This stuff is groundbreaking. Where do I even begin?
I think what our readers really want to know is whether we're any closer to finding out what happened to the Terror and her crew.
We've still got a lot of work to do to figure that out. Work. Jeffrey, you remember the concept?
Sorry, no time to chat, but have a look at what we already pulled out today. Might be interesting. Maggie, what are you waiting for? Activate the winch.
Huh? Oh, okay, I'll do it right away.
But what? No excuses. Come on, wake up. We've all got a job to do.
It's just that last time I checked, you were on winch duty.
Fine, I'm on it. Better than standing here all day arguing about who's supposed to do what anyway.
Are those the crew? It's been a long time since anyone found human remains from the Franklin expedition. This must be a landmark discovery, Dr. Gervais. Just 87 more and you'll have the full set.
Indeed, it's quite the breakthrough, but as is often the case with these discoveries, these remains pose more questions than answers. Why would so many of these men have remained on the ship? They could have risked it and tried to reach the continent on foot. Instead, they just waited here to die.
The expedition's not over yet. Maybe you'll find your answers.
Maybe, or maybe we'll never know.
Lieutenant, a decision must be made, and made quickly if we are to have any chance of surviving.
Mr. Woodruff, might I remind you that I am the last remaining officer on board? I, and I alone, will make the decisions about the crew on this ship.
There are barely 30 of us left. The summer ahead looks to be as cold as the last. Sir, we must abandon the Terror.
Abandon the Terror? Nonsense! you would be well advised to hold your tongue on such matters.
Sir, I beg you, please. Listen to me before it's too late.
If we leave now, I'm sure we can still...
The only thing you can be sure of, Woodruff, is that your next word on this will be your last. Campbell, you worthless layabout.
Aye, sir.
What's the status of the cannon?
In full working order, sir.
Yes, capital. Keep up the good work, lad. We'll make a sailor of you yet.
Thank you.
Mr. Woodruff? I need to speak with you about something I saw in Lieutenant Gore's cabin. I saw him writing in his logbook again this morning, but he seemed distressed. I was curious, so I took a look. My reading ain't so good, but it was nonsense, sir. The mindless ramblings of a madman, as far as I could tell. I'm worried he's beginning to crack under the pressure.
I see. You've done the right thing coming to me, lad.
Listen up, lads. You too, Gore. The lieutenant here is under the impression that we're about to be rescued. I'm sad to say I don't share his optimism.
Enough of your insubordination, Woodruff. I'll have you lashed if you say another word.
Lashed? Who'll be doing the lashing, Lieutenant? The Admiralty. Maybe one of your famous friends can help you.
What?
It's all here in the logbook, lads. The poor bugger's gone mad. He's gonna get us all killed.
These men are still loyal to me, Woodruff. Still loyal to the Crown.
Perhaps we should let the men answer for themselves, sir.
You have to say for yourself, Lieutenant.
Say for myself? I do not answer to you, Clark. I do not answer to any of you. Don't you see? I'm trying to help you. But you would rather follow Woodruff into an icy grave.
This ship is lost, Lieutenant. No one is coming for us. But it's not too late. Come south with us. There is still a chance, but we must act now.
I am still the commanding officer, Woodruff. And you're still a dirty, illiterate sailor. I say again, nobody will leave this ship.
We are going to leave this ship, and we're going to live to tell the tale. Mr. Woodruff will show us the way. I'm sure of it.
Give it up, Lieutenant. From now on, we'll put our faith in the Lord, not you.
All right, Gore. It's over. Men are with me. Am I getting off this godforsaken ship?
Scoundrels! Fools! He'll lead you to your graves, crucifixes by the shore. A pile of rocks atop your bones.
It's not too late, Lieutenant. You can still come with us.
You stole an officer's property, and then tricked these men with your lies about my writings. How could you understand? How could you possibly understand?
You're not thinking clearly, Lieutenant.
And why should these men trust a lowly wretch like you? Why, when you left England, you could barely write your own name.
Listen, you daft bastard. You're not in charge anymore.
You can come with us, or you can freeze to death here.
You're leading these men to their deaths, Woodruff. And I'll spill your blood before any of you leave this ship.
Keep your hands clean, Lieutenant.
Since anyone recovered human remains from the Franklin expedition. So this is a pretty big find, right?
I guess.
Ignore him. He's just trying to seem cool in front of the big shot reporter.
No, seriously. What more can we learn from a skull? I'm more interested in tools, personal effects.
But it looks like this one died of something other than lead poisoning and frostbite. See? The skull is fractured.
Mind if I take a closer look? Sailor had a filling back in 1845.
Who told you could touch that?
My guess would be an officer with a bullet in the forehead. Seems like close range. The whole thing sounds like mutiny to me.
What do you think about my mutiny theory?
Ha, I think you've been watching too much TV. No, there are plenty of explanations for what might have happened here. Well, if you'll excuse me, I have plenty of work to get on with. We can't let you fondle any more skulls for the moment.
Wait, but I thought...
We'll have What's-His-Face take you back to shore on the Zodiac. I'm sure you're eager to get a cup of hot coffee, but let's catch up tomorrow at base camp, yes? Fantastic. Off you go.
Nano will look for Saw tomorrow through the stories based on the patterns of nature. Floating in the cold ocean, Nanoholuk told its imagination to Kilat, the sky. Kilat listened in silence as they both stared far across distance and time.
You heard me right, David. Mutiny!
Well, I gotta hand it to you, kid. This is big. The Franklin Expedition is one of Canada's founding myths, but this could change everything we know about those last days on board the Terror. You have to keep snooping around, Dana. The story depends on it.
Yeah, about that. Gervais kinda gave me the old heave-ho. I'm heading back to shore now.
What? Oh, no. You're kidding me, right? Oh, you can't give up on a scoop like that. You're gonna have to...
That day?
That would be an understatement. My editor is expecting Pulitzer-winning material. But I think I just burned my only contact. On top of that, I'm freezing cold and this boat ride is making me want to hurl.
Sounds like you got things pretty rough.
You can say that again. Could I take a look at what's in there? I'll be quick. Scout's honor.
Huh? No way.
What? Seriously? How much damage could one girl do?
You could cost me my job. That's enough damage for you?
Money my editor set aside for...
That's flattering, miss, but my, charms are not for sale.
Wait, no, that's not what I meant.
Oh, I know exactly what you meant. But you can't buy me off, although seeing you squirm is kind of priceless.
You know The Discoverer, right? The magazine I work for? It's one of the biggest publications in the country. Circulation over 500,000.
You don't say?
When this article hits the stands, it's gonna make waves. How would you like a chance to ride them?
I'm not sure I follow.
I'm saying, why should Gervais get all the credit? How about this? The unsung heroes of archaeological research. Tell your side of the story. We can even get a nice shot of you in there, too.
Oh, yeah? My mother would be over the moon.
Really? Well, in that case, all I'd need is...
If she wasn't half blind from diabetes. But hey, maybe I could read it to her on a 3-hour snowmobile ride to the nearest hospital. Sorry, hotshot. Can't say I care about fame. Besides, who cares what people like me have to say?
What do you mean?
You see many Inuit on the news? You have many Inuit interviews lined up for your piece?
Well,
Yeah, I thought not. I know at least 3 elders who'd heard about the great European ships caught in the ice. They knew exactly where the Erebus was, but nobody listened. Guys like Gervais would rather poke around for decades than ask for help. They would have found the terror a long time ago if they had taken their heads out of their asses.
You know, you and I are actually on the same side.
Oh yeah? Me and the big shot journalist?
Why do you think Alan threw me off the boat? It's because I was getting too close to the truth.
Okay.
I'm serious. I want the world to know what really happened to the Franklin expedition. Not some colonial myth. I want the truth. The ugly truth. And I don't care who I piss off to get there. If the Inuit have a place in history, I can help you reclaim it. So what do you say?
You know, thinking about it, my snowmobile could do with some repairs. If your offer from before is still good, and you promise to stop talking about the truth for the rest of the ride back, I'll let you open one box.
For real?
One box.
You won't regret it. Sammy, right?
Cash only. No checks, okay?
Keep moving. Unless you want to freeze on the spot.
Commander, can I ask you a question?
You promised to stop with all this commander nonsense. Ask away.
I was wondering, how did you know that the Inuit were coming?
It's not easy to explain, William. Suluk appeared to me in a dream. I knew he'd come to help us.
Psh, poppycock. What's to say these savages won't eat us in our sleep?
I prefer salmon. More taste.
Don't worry. With our supplies and Kumak's hunting skills, we don't need to eat each other to survive. We must learn how to live alongside one another. Who knows, Henry? You may come to appreciate our new company.
You appreciate them all you like, sir. I choose to remain on guard till I'm back in England.
area along the road.
Patwa, kaduna tutu winak tuting lakit. Maksak jayang itwaloy.
What even is this language?
Show some respect, Henry.
Respect?
Ma, natak, atuat, naalakting ah.
Sunasulok.
Halo na, no? Kinyong magiyawot. Ikayo kaya katigit o kausing ato kisigyalibot.
Sumo, o kausitin ni ilitsingaktin nagi.
Upi maluak mata. Takoy na lang ako dito, kutoy na lang ako na ito.
Ay, suru, ilin ni mali lang abogot.
Thank you. ne piulinera halluna u haruti resimare suruti uva
tu kristiani roma tu samni tu tsarak
Hey,
sulivot it. What in the car of Mangilat it?
Come on, Kunuma good water in the cold water.
Hey, sulivot it. What in the car of Mangilat it?
Come on, Kununga good water in the cold water.
Suluk, tell me. You carved a symbol on the hull of the tower alongside us. What was it?
That was meant for you, Saima.
It was? I feel like I've seen it before. In a dream, maybe. But that's not possible.
That is possible. Are you certain?
Well, I've never experienced anything like it. What do you think it means?
It means you must trust me, that I'm your guide on this journey.
My guide? But to where? To civilization?
I cannot answer that, Simon. But know this. You are not the first to see this symbol, nor you will be the last.
Something bothering you?
Oh, it's nothing. Probably just a coincidence.
I love coincidences. Care to share?
Well, okay. Follow the line I'm making with my finger, right here. It might sound crazy, but I think I've seen this before. I don't know, maybe I dreamed it?
You dreamt it?
I don't know. I've been having these weird dreams lately. Maybe it's all the coffee I drink. Last night, there was this giant bear and... Why are you asking me this?
I have something that might interest you.
For my article?
For your article and not for your article. It might interest you either way. But you have to be prepared to listen.
That's why I'm here, Sammy. I told you.
Oh, you've told me plenty, but I'm not sure how much you listen. We're arriving at the port. You ever been on a quad before?
Most animals kill only in proportion to their needs. Others kill out of fear. But this fear causes an illness that festers when not addressed. Nanuruluk understood that the only cure was to make the wrong right.
Well, this is the place. I'm gonna start a fire so we don't freeze to death out here. Hope the ride wasn't too bumpy.
I promise I will never complain about Montreal public transport again.
Come on, it wasn't that bad. Okay, maybe it was that bad.
So why do you want to show me this place? What's so special about it?
Remember that symbol you showed me from the terror? I've heard elders talk about seeing something similar at this Inuksuk.
Okay, I guess I can take a look around.
Look.
What have you got there?
I found something between the stones of this Inuksuk, some kind of tin cylinder. It's got a note inside written in English.
What this Inukshuk means?
Not sure really, but whatever it is, it's not a good omen.
What makes you say that?
For the Inuit people, human-shaped Inuksuk sometimes act as a warning. Someone may have died here, or they were murdered. Now their spirit is haunting this place.
Well, are you going to show me this letter, or are we just going to stand around till we freeze to death?
Sure, take a look. See that symbol? Looks kind of like the one from the boat, right?
Commander?
One moment, William. Let me finish my message. And enough with this commander nonsense. Now, what is it?
Sir, this place is exposed. And with this blizzard coming, shouldn't we think about leaving soon?
Indeed we should. The problem is Suluk. His condition has deteriorated, and he's too weak to walk.
Do not worry about me, Samo. My journey goes more far than here.
I hope so, Suluk, because I... Suluk? Damn. He's fallen unconscious. William, quickly. There's something wrong.
I'll do my best, Commander, but... the Inuit have been showing signs of weakness for some time now.
We all have.
But this is different. It's not just exhaustion, it's... well, I don't know what it is.
Some doctor you are.
I never claimed to be a doctor, you raggedy arse.
Enough bickering. There has to be a rational explanation.
If there is, we may not have time to look for it. We're freezing out here.
We must find some way to help the Inuit. They're counting on us. Reuben. See if there's anything we can do for them.
Aye, sir.
Commander, if we have to leave now, I'd like to give a few things to our friends.
You're a fine lad, Reuben. I was thinking along the same lines. What do you propose?
I'm not sure. A lamp could be useful in the dark. Binoculars might help them spot game and plan a route ahead. But with them too weak to hunt right now, I think some of our food would be helpful too.
Commander, I appreciate the help these folks have given us, but that's more than we owe them. We have to think of ourselves right now. We'll need that food if we're to reach the mainland.
We've travelled side by side for months, Josephus. Have you no compassion for your fellow man?
Reuben, do as you see fit. I trust you to help the Inuit without endangering us.
Understood, Commander.
What do you think, William? You don't buy this talk of curses, do you?
I'm no doctor, Commander.
And I'm no commander, William. But we're making do as best as we can. Come, speak your mind.
I've spent enough time with doctors to see how the human body can confound men of science. But in the end, there's always an explanation for everything.
Any thoughts?
Scurvy, botulism. Typhoid, maybe. For now, I have no idea what the disease is. Those medical books we brought from the ship's library could shed some light on the matter. You seem concerned, Atuat?
I am, Willia. I can hardly see Suluk's homonic.
His... cowmonic?
Homonic means light. I can feel his light weakening. I'm worried about him. Thank you for the food, Halukallak, even if it burns my stomach.
I'll admit it's not fine dining. But I hope it helps you and your people, Atuat. I only wish there were more we could do.
Thank you.
Well, William, what's your verdict?
We can rule out scurvy, typhoid, or dysentery. The only possible diagnosis left would be some sort of poisoning.
It is a sickness of the unbelievers. It devours them from within. Better that we don't risk catching it.
Please, Henry, spare us the sermon.
Are you going to show me this letter, or are we just going to stand around till we freeze to death?
Sure, take a look. See that symbol? Looks kind of like the one from the boat, right?
If the sailors left cans here, it must have been for a reason.
Maybe they got sick of eating the same old stuff?
Take it from someone who worked freelance. Eating crap is better than starving to death. Didn't one of the scientists say something about canned goods in the 19th century? Maggie, I think.
I don't know. They always make me stay with the Zodiac.
It was the sealing process. The lead they used to seal the cans contaminated the food. European sailors back then would have built up a tolerance for lead.
But for the Inuit, it would have been a hell of a shock to the system. You could be onto something there.
Take a look at these cans for me. Does anything strike you as odd about them?
Let me see. You're right, sir. The lead solder on the cans is damaged. It's turned green. It's flaking. But if it's the canned food, why aren't we sick too? We've been eating it for years.
That's precisely it. We each had a lifetime eating slop on the Navy. Or is the Inuit who lived off the land? That might explain why it's affected them as it has. We must get rid of these tainted preserves. From now on, we eat only what we hunt.
Remarkable, Commander. You may just have saved Suluk and the Inuit from certain death.
Friends, this Inuksuk? Have you lost all hope for me?
We thought you entered the spirit world, Suluk, but your helmet shines again.
What's so funny?
For us, man-shaped Inuksuit can be a reminder that someone has passed.
It's like waking up finding your friends but crossed in the ground above your head.
But you are an Anikatu, Suluk. A dead man brought back to life.
If that's so, let's replace this symbol with an Inuksuk that will indicate to our destination.
Very well. I'll leave a message for the rescue party. Gentlemen, empty one of the boats. Suluk and his people have dragged our sorry arses this far. It's time we return the favor.
Ta-da!
Well, bravo, I guess?
You ask why I brought you here. I'm trying to show you.
The film reel looks ancient. You sure it's okay to put it up there like that?
What? Like I'm gonna unspool it on the ground? Nah, this way you can see the whole thing.
What whole thing?
The whole story.
Can you stop talking in riddles for 1 minute and tell me what any of this has to do with the terror?
I was building up to that. Jeez, you're ruining the suspense. Remember when I found that tin cylinder in the Inuksuk? There was a note inside. Here.
Sammy, it's that symbol again.
See, as soon as you showed it to me, I remembered hearing stories about it showing up here. It didn't mean much at the time, but, well, here it is.
Incredible. This is incredible. Operation Borealis. What the hell is that?
Hey, don't mess with that. That one's never been opened. I don't even know what's on it.
me, this film, you said it was from your aunt?
More of a family friend. She gave it to me when I was a kid because I used to love the story it told. The weird thing is, she contacted me a few days ago and asked if I still had it. She said I should keep it with me, that someone would be interested in it. Guess she was talking about you.
But how could she have known?
She knows all kinds of things.
Do you think she might know anything about the terror?
Maybe you could ask her yourself. She lives pretty far away, though, a place southeast of here.
How does she feel about visitors?
So long as you like hearing old stories, you'll get on like a house on fire. There's another reel too, but this one's sealed. I've never been able to get it developed.
Well, I guess I could help with that. It's gonna cost a fortune, but that's what company credit cards are for. Sammy.
More of a family friend. She gave it to me when I was a kid because I used to love the story it told. The weird thing is, she contacted me a few days ago and asked if I still had it. She said I should keep it with me, that someone would be interested in it. Guess she was talking about you.
But how?
She knows all kinds of things. She even mentioned this place.
Do you think she...
Maybe you...
How does she feel?
So there's...
Well, I... I'm following up. It's kind of hard to explain.
Try me.
It looks like they may have headed south after they abandoned the terror.
So what? I sent you to be there when they brought the ship out of the water.
Think about it, David. No one's ever accounted for all of the crew of the terror. And we might have found evidence that they had help in surviving.
I suppose there might be a story there, but where were they going?
That I don't know, but I think I could find out. I just need a couple of things from you.
What kind of things are we talking?
First, I have a reel of film I want to send your way. I'd like to have it developed ASAP.
This is all suspiciously reasonable so far.
Also, I need some funds. I was hoping I could use the magazine's credit card.
There it is. All right, how much? And who are you paying it to?
A good journalist never reveals her sources.
Since when are you a good journalist?
I won't screw up, David. I promise.
Beyond the horizon lived three hunters who killed to prove themselves. Shame, hate, and pride passed down through generations, fueling their actions. Their egos knew no hunger as they marked all of their kills and belongings.
Gentlemen, welcome to the ass end of nowhere. Make yourselves at home. In the coming weeks, you will be sleeping in dirt. You will be bathing in ice-cold streams. And you will be defecating in bushes. So before we commence Operation Borealis, why don't you remind the boys of the facts, Lieutenant?
Sir, a few weeks ago, we got word of an unidentified object crash-landing south of our current position. Command believes that this object is a meteorite, and they've ordered a team to locate said meteorite and perform the necessary analysis.
Accurate as always, Humphrey. Now, because it is critical that we document our findings, we have a civilian along for the ride. I trust that you've already given him a warm welcome.
Not every day us grunts get to channel our inner Brando. Just make sure you stay on my good side. Okay, Petey?
I'll try my best, Lieutenant. Soon as I, find my equipment, that is. Without my camera, there isn't gonna be much of a film.
It must have been delivered with the rest of the gear.
Well, get the lead out of your ass. We're moving out this afternoon, whether you're ready or not. Lieutenant?
Sir.
I know I don't need to tell you again, but this operation needs a light touch. I trust you'll keep your men in line. Even the pipsqueak.
He'll be on a tight leash, sir. Besides, I think he's more interested in futzing with his camera.
Well, be that as it may, you don't need to tell him anything he doesn't need to know. Oh, another thing. We'll need the cooperation of the locals on this, so...
So keep leering away from them at all times. Got it, sir.
Well, good hunting, Humph. You're the only one I can trust with this.
Thank you, sir. We won't let you down.
Sure is a lot of gear for a mission this size. What's it all for?
Hey, you didn't say any of that, okay?
Say, I think I've seen one of those before. Is that a Geiger counter?
Hey, who left that tent open?
Sir, that was me. I was taking inventory.
How about next time you don't let the civvy go poking around our gear? Huh, Green?
What's your plan with that? You looking for uranium?
Hey, Peter. I think I saw some rocks over there with some weird markings on them. Now you've got your camera, why don't you go get some shots, huh?
I was just wondering why you...
That was an order, Pete. I'll make it clearer in the future.
Yes, sir.
Thank you. I thought we'd never see trees again.
How long has it been?
3 years?
Almost four. But that means we're on the right track. All thanks to you, Commander.
I thought I told you all to stop with this Commander nonsense.
I'm sorry, sir. Perhaps Captain would be more to your liking. Admiral, maybe.
Ah.
Much like an Inukshuk, these trees are a symbol. A symbol of our salvation.
Game should be plentiful here.
And, more importantly, this is the gateway to the south, to civilization. No offense.
Suluk, do you know the meaning of the symbols on these rocks?
I do not. I have heard of similar markings, but it is said they came along before me and my people.
And yet they've lasted all this time. Incredible. In that case, we should leave our own mark. A sign of our passage.
Josephus, you used to draw all the time on the boat. I'd like you to be in charge of the carving.
I drew on paper, not rock.
You're a resourceful man, Josephus. I trust you to figure things out.
If it's important to you, I'll do my best. What would you like me to carve?
I shall leave that to you, my friend.
Follow your inspiration. Let it guide your hand.
We'll need to find a suitable place to leave our mark.
Let's look around.
The spot do, Commander?
Perfect, Josephus. This will be seen from a distance. Now get your tools and start carving.
Thank you.
This tree looks good. I think I can cut it. Halukala, Homa. I believe I can cut this tree down. It isn't too big and I'm sure it will burn well.
Very well. Change of plan. Go ahead, Atuit. Cormac, I think my tree's the best candidate for firewood. I'll start chopping.
Ruben, Atuat, listen, I think this tree will burn better than the other two. I will cut this tree for us.
Very well. Change your plan. Go ahead, Cormac. Cormac, I think my tree's the best candidate for firewood. I'll start chopping. get to it, Cormac. I think my tree's the best candidate for firewood. I'll start chopping.
Peter, pack up your gear. We're moving out.
Yes, sir. I'll be right there.
You who are wise, what do you think of our celebration?
Commander, we needed a little party.
I was wondering, Commander, how will we get back to Britain once we've reached the mainland?
Britain? How can you think of dreary old Britain at a time like this? Enjoy yourself, Josephus.
I'll enjoy myself when I return to my family, Commander.
What do you think of this ceremony, Suluk?
I think we forgot to feel dry along the way. Thank you for reminding us, Saima. These engravings used to be made for you. I don't understand them. Thank you.
Enough prattling around. To bed, gentlemen. We still have a long road ahead of us.
The hunters believed they could gain respect by killing Nanoholuk. The enormous carcass would remind everyone of their superior strength and cunning. They imagined the praise they would receive reaching out beyond tomorrow.
Lieutenant, you're back. How was the village?
A welcome break from your sorry hides, believe me. The locals have kindly given us permission to set up camp here for the night if we need to.
Don't they have a house for us to stay in or something? I haven't slept in a bed for weeks.
Oh, quit your whining, soldier. I can't risk you making an ass of us in front of our hosts. Besides, we've got work to do here. A few more nights on your bedroll won't do you any harm. So, enough lollygagging. Laren, I want Geiger readings, ASAP. Green, geological analysis of any debris in the area. Get those thumbs out of your asses.
Readings. They aren't consistent with... with what we've been looking for.
You mean the meteorite?
Oh, sure, yeah. The meteorite. wrong kind of cosmic radiation. What are you hoping to find with that thing?
This? You know, your standard X-rays, cosmic rays, gamma, delta. All kinds. I read that... Oh, you read something, Point Dexter? Do me a favor and stick to your books and your little movies. The real science happens out here, in the field.
I was speaking with the elders in the village just now. They confirm reports of a meteor shower in the area, with multiple sources reporting an object striking a nearby lake.
And you believe them? What if they've been, you know, smoking the old peace pipe?
I trust them more than I trust you, dumbass.
So, when do we head to this crater?
We need to be sure of a few things before we make any decisions.
Sir, it looks like we've got meteorite fragments here.
That's good, right? It means we're on the right track.
Sure. Right on track, kid.
Can I please go meet some of the villagers? It'd be great for my
That just ain't part of the mission, Pete. Besides, why would I subject these good people to your endless questions? You're complaining?
Okay, I get it.
Griping, bitching, moaning, and talking. Don't forget plain old talking. On and on and on.
A simple no would have been fine.
Yeah, but where's the fun in that, Pete?
right, listen up. All signs point to a meteorite striking the lake nearby. This exercise is over. Pack up your gear, we're moving out in the morning.
Wait, what? We've just found what we were looking for.
Not exactly.
What are you talking about?
Military's got no interest in a meteorite, kid. No point hiding it any longer. We were looking for a Soviet missile we believe may have crashed nearby.
Missile? But... So you lied to me. Why?
We kinda needed your camera, and we needed someone to operate it.
And we knew a beatnik like you wouldn't come along if we told you we were hunting rockets.
You were the best candidate at short notice.
You used me.
Come on, kid. You used us, too. You got the trip of a lifetime, and your own personal armed guard while you got your shots.
So that's it? You came all this way to give up?
I came all this way to see if the Russians were firing missiles at my country. Quite frankly, I'm pretty pleased at how things have turned out.
Fine. Then you won't mind if I go and see this crash site for myself.
Wish that was possible, kid, but I can't let a civvy wander off alone on my watch.
Oh yeah? And how are you gonna stop me? You gonna hold me at gunpoint?
I could hold him at gunpoint, sir.
No need. You don't go anywhere without this thing. You said so yourself. Property of the Canadian Army now, kid.
Son of a... My camera! And you think that'll keep me from leaving? I'm out of here.
Go sulk all you want, kid. Years from now, when you're not lying dead in a ditch, you'll thank me.
So, this is the journalist Sammy has told me so much about, hey?
Only the good parts, I hope.
Dinah had some questions for you, Nuna.
Well, I imagine she would, being a journalist. Please, ask away.
Thank you.
Taina, the journalist. What do you think of our little village so far?
I didn't know the Inuit lived so far south. How did you end up here?
Many years ago, our ancestors found a group of white men lost in the north. They had sailed their ship into the ice pack and got themselves stuck, as they are so fond of doing.
The Terror!
Yes, I imagine they were very scared.
No, I meant...
Don't interrupt. As I was saying, they were found by my ancestors, lost in the ice, searching for a way home. The Inuit took pity on this band of fools and greeted them to help them travel to the south. But on the way, they found this place. It might not just seem much to you, but there's enough fish and game to sustain us. And all these generations later, you've come to call it home.
David, glad I caught you. I'm at the...
Is this some sort of goddamn joke to you, Tana? Do you have any idea how much it costs to have a film reel from the 50s developed?
David, slow down a minute. What are you talking about?
It's a dumbass shutting off a camera, you moron. You had us go through all that trouble for this.
That can't be. Why would...
This is exactly what I was worried about when I put you on this. You've got your head shoved so far up your ass, you can't even do the simple things right. Right now, scientists are finally uncovering what happened to the Franklin expedition. And my ace reporter is miles away, following some hunch about a failed military operation. We're done. Book a flight home. I'll take it out of your last paycheck. And don't bother coming in on Monday.
What the? You piece of shit.
Something wrong?
Something wrong? I've just lost my goddamn job because of you.
Because of me? What are you talking about?
That film reel you gave me is a dud, and now I've flown all the way out to the middle of nowhere. I bet my career on a lead I got from a scruffy-looking loser on a Zodiac. Jesus Christ, what have I done?
What's the matter? Taina, the journalist? No matches on your Tinder out here in the wildness.
What? No, it's the film reel you gave to Sammy years ago. There's nothing on there. Nothing of interest, anyway. And my boss is... Well, he might not be my boss anymore.
Film? Reel?
The film reel you gave to Sammy when he was a kid? Remember? Operation Borealis?
Borealis, forgive me. Things are a little, foggy.
Remember, Nuna? From the filmmaker you met when you were young.
Filmmaker? I'm sorry. Things are... Wait. Ah, it's you, isn't it?
Huh?
What have you been up to?
Who, me?
No, not you. Doesn't matter. The filmmaker. Peter was his name. I remember. He was following the path of another white man. A red-headed man who was here long before him. But he wouldn't listen to what I had to say.
Strange job for the military, wouldn't you say?
It's kind of a long story, but I don't think they're interested in shooting stars anymore. They want to go back to shooting people instead.
Ah, you sound disappointed.
I have to find that meteorite. I feel like there's something there for me. The lieutenant mentioned that people from your village saw where it landed. Do you know where that place is?
Yes, but...
Great! You can show me the way!
I am sorry, Peter, but I can't do that for you.
Huh? Why not?
I know the spot where that thing landed. We don't go around there. It's hard to explain. You don't seem like a soldier. I can't imagine you carrying a gun. What are you doing out here with these men?
Well, do you know what a film is? A movie?
Movie?
Oh boy, where do I start? You see, when you take a series of still images and...
I'm making fun of you, Peter.
Oh, well, of course.
So you're here to make movies?
I was. But those meatheads took my camera away to stop me leaving the camp.
Confused by this thing.
A ship's anchor? Miles inland from the sea? I'll admit, it's a little confusing. The white men you mentioned, did they bring it here?
Yes, that's right. Among the people who founded our community were some white men, sailors who arrived from the north.
Really? And they're the ones that brought that thing here?
Yes, they did. Or so the story goes. They dragged it all the way from their boat. The Inuit that accompanied them saw no sense in bringing it. But the leader of the white men, a red-headed man they called Commander, was insistent.
Man you mentioned. It might sound stupid, but I feel like I'm connected to him somehow. It's like our fates are linked. I can feel it.
I wouldn't be so excited to share this man's fate. I told you, he never returned from that frozen lake.
Listen, Nuna. This is going to sound weird, but I have to go to this lake and film it. This is what I do. What I have to do. But I can't do it without your help. So, will you help me?
I'll think about it. Would you like to know the story behind this anchor?
Well, yes, of course, but
among the people who founded our community were some white men, sailors who arrived from the north.
Really? And they're the ones that brought that thing here?
Yes, they did, or so the story goes. They dragged it all the way from their boat. The Inuit that accompanied them saw no sense in bringing it. But the leader of the white men, a red-headed man, was insistent. Film of yours, is the red-headed man a part of it?
That depends. What can you tell me about him?
Only what I've been told by the elders in this village. He had flame-red hair, a long stride. He was respectful of the Inuit, for the most part. They say he was driven by a vision he saw in a dream. He believed it was his destiny to lead his men to safety and form a community here. In a sense, he achieved that. But not long after he arrived in this region, he walked out onto the ice on a nearby lake. And he was never seen or heard from again.
Can you show me where those two men went? The filmmaker and the red-headed man?
I'll tell you what I told that boy all those years ago. We don't go around there. Two people have gone there and never came back. You wish to be the third?
No, I'll be the first to come back.
And what makes you think that you're different from them?
Because I'm going to be the one who tells the story. I can feel something. Call it fate, destiny, whatever. I don't know why, but I was meant to tell this story to the world.
How can you tell a story that you don't even fully understand?
Peter! Peter! Oh, goddammit, where did he go?
That asshole. He's probably gone native, decided to go live in a hut with the locals or something. You ask me? I say we leave without him.
That is exactly why I didn't ask you, Laren. How about you shut your damn mouth for a change and start looking for him?
He can't have gotten far. Besides, it'll be night soon. He's not dumb enough to wander off on his own.
Okay, I've had enough of this bullshit. We've looked everywhere. He's probably run off after that meteorite. Green, call for evac. Have the plane ready to meet us on the lake south of here.
But Lieutenant, he's still out there.
We're not leaving without him. We'll send up a flare at the evac point. If the dumb bastard's got any sense, he'll come meet us.
And if he doesn't?
Then he's got his camera. He'll get a chance to make the film he's always dreamed of. All right, get the lead out. Let's move.
Thank you.
Here you go.
My camera! How did you...
I can track a caribou for miles without it knowing I was there. I think I can steal a bag from some fat-headed soldiers, don't you?
I'm genuinely impressed.
Enough talk. We should leave for the crater before it's dark.
Lead on.
Let's see what we have here.
Is that the film?
Yeah, it's hard to make out, but I think this filmmaker, Peter, I think he came through here on the way to...
On the way to what?
Some kind of frozen lake. So that's where they went. Nuna, do you know the best way to this lake in the video?
I know the way, yes.
Great! If you could just...
But I won't go to that place.
Wait, what? Why not?
The place you're going, where the boy Peter went, and where the man Simon Woodruff went, this is a place from which they did not return. This is a place where no one should go.
I don't need you to take me. I just need you to show me the way.
I have shown the way before. It was for the worse. I don't want to do it again.
Okay, fine. I'll take you to the damn lake. But we take a look and that's it, okay?
You're not scared of some old story, are you, Sammy?
You should heed the warning of the stories. Dana, you should be scared of this place.
She's with me, Nuna. She'll be fine. She might look like she'd rather be at brunch, but she's pretty tough.
I said what I said. I won't go to that place. You two do what you have to do. Suddenly, the hunter's steps grew louder. Nanoro look had no wish to die. There were too many stories left to tell, but it couldn't ignore what had to pass. Bones cracked, the skin is pierced, and organs fail as it cried out in agony.
Remind me one more time. What are we doing all the way out here when we could be back with the others?
Our beloved commander thinks this is the best spot for a camp. Wants to make sure the area is safe before we bring the rest of the party here. And who are we to question His Highness?
I don't know why you and your people are so afraid of this place, Suluk. Looks perfectly safe to me.
You are wrong, Saima. A great danger lurks here.
So you keep telling me, but that's why we brought the cannon. Whatever it is out there, we can scare it off with a warning shot.
If you think you can conquer this place with weapons, you are mistaken.
With all due respect, Suluk, you have never seen our weapons in action.
I do not need to see them to know that this will fail.
After all this time together, all of our long chats by the fire, you still doubt me? Well, no matter. Soon, I will make this place safe for habitation. This will be the site of a community.
Come on now, these men don't know what they're doing. You're not serious about firing this thing, are you?
Watch your damn mouth! Who the hell do you think you're talking to? I've served on ships since I was a lad. Started out as a powder boy. I think I know my way around a bloody cannon. And you'll address me as Commander, McCannigan.
My sincerest apologies, Commander.
Target. Can you?
Just do as he says for now, lad. We'll be warming ourselves by the fire before you know it.
But...
no point arguing with him when he's in one of his moods. And what's the worst that could happen?
Thank you.
don't suppose this is a time or place, but have you given any further thought to our discussion from the other night?
This again? I haven't the time for your whining about Scotland. Besides, can't you see I'm busy?
But busy with what exactly? I mean, we're out here playing silly buggers with the ship's artillery. And we should be thinking about how to get home.
Home? You think there's a home for you back there?
I have a family.
Aye. Some ruddy-faced crone and a shrieking bairn. Face it, Josephus. You're already a dead man to that family of yours. No. You're a nomad like the rest of us. You have no home to return to. The sooner you accept that, the sooner you can start a new life.
Sema, this place is not safe. We should go back. Where is the other set up camp?
Camp? That's not our camp, Suluk. This is the camp. Right here. Our new home. This is where we were meant to be. You say it isn't safe? That's why we brought protection. We have our cannon.
If you stay here, you and your men are in danger.
That's where you're wrong, my superstitious friend. See that island over there? I've seen it before. In my dream. We were meant to come here. You were meant to guide us. And I was meant to create a community. Right here, in this very spot. You've performed your task, Suluk. Now let me perform mine.
This must be it. This must be where the survivors of the terror ended up. Not to mention the missing kid with the camera.
So, what are we looking for here?
Anything that can give us clues to where the Simon Woodruff guy and the filmmaker went.
I don't see anything. Looks like no one's been through here in, well, forever.
Well, look harder. I'm not leaving here empty-handed. I put my career on the line for this lead. It can't have been for nothing.
I know, but I have a bad feeling about this place. I don't think we should stick around here too long if we can avoid it.
You're the one that's brought us here, so stop acting like a scared kid and start helping.
We made it! There's the lake. Oh, this must be where the meteorite hit. Damn, it's cold.
I have a bad feeling about this place, Peter.
Shh! Wait. What the hell is that noise? It sounds almost like a plane engine.
Quick, we need to hide.
Hide? I didn't come all this way to hide.
Would you please get down?
What's the matter? Never seen a plane before?
I've seen planes before.
Then what's got you so spooked? They're looking for me, not you.
Planes come to take children to school.
What's so bad about school? School's great. You learn things.
You don't understand. When they take children away to school, they don't come back.
Huh? Stop being such a fraidy cat. Come on! We've got more important things to worry about. See that island? I've dreamed about that island. And it's exactly how I remember it. There must be a way across. I didn't think polar bears lived this far south.
This is not a good sign, Peter. We should turn back.
Turn back? And miss this shot? Not a chance. I have to get closer to that bear.
Listen to yourself, you foolish boy. If you come within a few feet of that thing, it'll tear you apart.
I'm not gonna go poke it with a stick, dummy. I just want to get close enough to get a good shot for my film. This is a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity.
It will be a short lifetime unless you listen to me. There are things here that you don't understand.
Oh yeah? And you do? What do you know?
I know enough not to mess with things that are beyond my grasp.
Your grasp, not mine. When I see something inexplicable, something incredible, I don't turn tail and run away. I record it. I capture it. I study it. I understand it. Maybe if you did the same, you wouldn't hide every time you hear a plane engine.
It's so dark.
Shit, car battery's dead. Lights are out. This isn't good.
Shit. Why does this kind of thing always happen to me?
Hey, come on. So it's a little dark. I think if we...
Shh! You see that over there?
See what?
Like a white bear. Over there, on that island.
I don't see anything. Besides, you don't get polar bears this far south. Although I'll admit, it is getting kind of cold. Maybe the next ice age is on the way?
Is it alive? It's so still. It's so peaceful.
Gentlemen, the time has come to assert our superiority. The beast on this island will face our might. Ready? Aim! Fire! I said, fire! That's an order! I said, fire! That's an order!
I'm sorry, Commander, but we left the last few matches we got at the camp. I'm looking for something else to light the fuse.
What's taking so long with that cannon?
The fuse is damp, sir. I can't get the damn thing to light.
Well, then keep trying.
Please, we need to leave. I have...
A bad feeling? Yeah, I heard. Jeez. You know, you seemed so cool when you were stealing my camera back. But since then, it's just been planes this, school that. I have a bad feeling, I'm scared. Let me tell you something. You want to make something of yourself in this life? You gotta overcome that fear. You think I had it easy? I've been kicked around my whole life. Guys at school, those army meatheads, they see a little guy they can push over. And don't get me started on those hacks in the film industry. But I'm gonna show them. I'll show all of them. No one pushes me around, no one.
They're probably worried about you.
You can tell that from all the way down here, eh? You'll have to share your mystical wisdom with me sometime.
Listen to me, you stupid boy. They want to take you home.
I don't need to go home!
Don't you see? You can't stay here. The longer you're here, the more people will come sniffing around our community, searching for you. You're hurting us by staying here.
Oh, I'm not welcome anymore, huh? So what's new? I never fit in anywhere. Why should here be any different?
Peter, please, stop feeling sorry for yourself and listen to me.
Look, if you're not gonna help me, why don't you go back to your precious community? I've got things I need to do.
Peter, please hide.
Look, I appreciate the help, kid. But if you're gonna keep on with this hiding stuff, you can head on home.
You know, this has been quite the adventure, but maybe it's time we thought about turning back.
And give up? Ha! You like that. They'd all like that. This is your last chance, Tina. Don't let me down. Yeah, kiss my ass, David. I'll break this story without him and his snooty magazine.
Come on, take a seat. The spooky island isn't going anywhere for now.
We need to get over there. That's where the story is. That's where I need to be.
Just take it easy for a minute, okay?
Take it easy? I didn't get where I am by taking it easy. No, I had to work my ass off to get where I am. Work harder than anyone. No, you wouldn't understand. You probably just get high, play video games. No one's gonna hand you anything for sitting around, Sammy. You've got to go out there and take what you want.
You're shivering.
I'm fine.
But it's getting colder.
So? You got a coat, don't you?
But it shouldn't be this cold here. It's summer. There's something strange here.
I'm not letting some bad weather stop me. This is where I'm meant to be. Across the water is something that's going to change my life. Change my career. I can feel it. There's no way I'm turning back.
I've got a light!
Good work, Reuben. I knew you wouldn't let me down. Reuben! William! Henry! Josephus! Report in!
Ah! My ears! What happened?
Where are the rest?
They are dead, Simon.
Nonsense! Now they just can't hear us! Reuben! Reuben, my lad!
Oh, God! What have you done?
Stop your whimpering and help me find them!
They are dead, Simon.
That cannon was in no condition to fire. I told you. We all told you. You fool.
No. No, they're fine. Reuben! William! Henry!
You killed them.
Enough!
You promised you'd lead them home, and you killed them. What are you talking about?
Out there on the island. Just like I said.
I think you finally cracked, Woodruff.
It is too late for him. He is now truly lost to us. Simon, look around you. You cannot see what you're doing.
I have to. There's still something I need to do.
Ah, let him go. He can die out there for all I care.
Don't worry, my friends. I'll come back.
No, I do not think you will.
Then, perhaps this is goodbye.
That island. It's exactly how I pictured it. And look, there's a way over.
Peter, wait. I have a bad feeling about this place.
We can make it across those rocks there. See?
I don't want to go, Peter. And I don't want you to go either.
Then you don't have to. Just keep a hold of my gear, okay?
Peter, please don't go over there. No good can come of it.
I'll be back, I promise. I need those film reels, remember?
Look, I think there's a way across to the island.
You're not thinking of going, right?
Why wouldn't I?
I know this is going to sound stupid to you, but something isn't right about this place. I have this feeling...
Your feelings lost me my goddamn job, Sammy, remember?
Look, I'm sorry about that, but staying out here isn't going to fix anything.
The only thing that's gonna fix any of this is me breaking this story. It's my last hope. If you'd ever had anything to lose, maybe you'd understand.
Hey, now, wait a minute. I'm sorry about what happened with your job. It seems like you were good at it. But it sounds like you had a knack for getting on the wrong side of your boss before you met me.
What's that supposed to mean?
It means that maybe, just maybe,
You're not the easiest person to work with 100% of the time.
Oh, so now I'm getting lectured on interpersonal skills by a guy whose colleagues barely remember his name. Why don't you sit tight and let me do my job, or what's left of it anyway?
Wait, what are you doing?
The hell you care?
I'm sorry about before. I do care. I just don't want to see you get hurt.
Your concern is touching, but I don't need you looking out for me.
Wait, listen to me. I don't know. There's just something very wrong with this place.
All the more reason to go out there and get some answers.
Wait, but...
Don't worry about me. This is my story. And it's only just getting started.
Nanook Luke's story extended beyond tomorrow. Living in the stars, but the hunters couldn't hear it. Instead, they believed the story was their own. They'd never stopped telling it, over and over, in all places, at all times. Animals kill in proportion to their needs. And Nanook knew that the cure was to make the wrong right. So she made sure the hunters left a trail of death to warn any who would follow their path.